মাইসেলফ ডক্টর স্বাতী মুখোপাধ্যায়, ওয়ার্কিং অ্যাজ অ্যান অ্যাসিস্ট্যান্ট প্রফেসর ইন দি ডিপার্টমেন্ট অফ ম্যাথমেটিক্স, দি ইউনিভার্সিটি অফ বারডোয়ান, ওয়েস্ট বেঙ্গল। টুডে উই আর গোয়িং টু স্টার্ট মডিউল ওয়ান অফ চ্যাপ্টার ওয়ান। ইন দিস মডিউল উই আর ইন্টারেস্টেড টু ডিসকাস দি রোটেটিং কোঅর্ডিনেট সিস্টেম। ইন ইয়োর আন্ডার গ্র্যাজুয়েট ক্লাসেস ইউ হ্যাভ লার্নড দি মোশন অফ এ পার্টিকেল অর এ বডি ইন অ্যান ইনার্শিয়াল ফ্রেম ইন হুইচ নিউটনস লজ অফ মোশন, পার্টিকুলারলি নিউটনস সেকেন্ড ল অফ মোশন অর ডি অ্যালেম্বার্টস প্রিন্সিপল আর ভ্যালিড, বাট দেয়ার আর সাম ফ্রেমস হুইচ আর রোটেটিং। রোটেটিং ফ্রেমস আর অলসো নোন অ্যাজ অ্যাক্সিলারেটেড ফ্রেমস। ইন সাচ ফ্রেমস দিজ ইকুয়েশনস অফ মোশন আর টু বি আপডেটেড অর মডিফাইড। ফর এক্সাম্পল, উই ক্যান কনসিডার দি মোশন অফ এ পার্টিকেল অর এ রিজিড বডি অন আর্থ সারফেস। ফর দিস রিজন উই হ্যাভ টু ডিস্টিংগুইশ বিটুইন ইনার্শিয়াল অ্যান্ড নন ইনার্শিয়াল ফ্রেমস। ইন দিস মডিউল উই আর ইন্টারেস্টেড টু ডিসকাস দি ডিস্টিংশন বিটুইন ইনার্শিয়াল অ্যান্ড নন ইনার্শিয়াল ফ্রেমস। দেন উই শ্যাল ডিসকাস দি নেসেসিটি অফ রোটেটিং সিস্টেম। ডেরিভেশন অফ টাইম ডেরিভেটিভ অফ এ ভেক্টর ইন সাচ ফ্রেম উইল অলসো বি ডিসকাসড। নেক্সট উই শ্যাল অবটেন দি ভেলোসিটি, অ্যাক্সিলারেশন অ্যান্ড ফোর্স ইন সাচ এ সিস্টেম। After that, equation of motion in a rotating frame of reference will be obtained. Next, what do you mean by an inertial frame? A frame is said to be inertial if Newton's laws of motion, particularly Newton's second law of motion, hold in that system. For example, consider any frame moving with uniform velocity with respect to a fixed frame is an example of inertial frame. Next, non-inertial frame. A frame is said to be non-inertial if Newton's second law of motion does not hold in that system. That is, such frame is not tied to the state of motion of an observer. As an example, one can consider a rotating frame. This is an example of non-inertial frame. Now we are interested to obtain the time derivative of a vector in a rotating frame. Please go through this figure 1.1. In this figure, two systems S and S dash have been considered. In S system, three coordinate axes OX, OY, OZ are shown, whereas in S dash system, OX dash, OY dash, OZ dash have been shown. In S dash system, I, J, K are the unit vectors along OX dash, OY dash and OZ dash axes respectively. Let alpha equal to alpha function of t be any vector where alpha is given by alpha 1 I vector plus alpha 2 j vector plus alpha 3 k vector. Then we are interested to obtain the rate of change of alpha vector with respect to time t as estimated by an observer fixed on the frame S, which is again a fixed frame. The rate of change of alpha vector is given by d dt of alpha vector equals to d alpha 1 dt I vector plus alpha 1 d dt of I vector plus d dt of alpha 2 into j vector plus alpha 2 into d dt of j vector plus d dt of alpha 3 into k vector plus alpha 3 into d dt of k vector. equals to d alpha 1 dt I vector plus d alpha 2 dt j vector plus d alpha 3 dt k vector plus alpha 1 di vector dt plus alpha 2 dj vector dt plus alpha 3 dk vector dt. Please note that here I, j, k are unit vectors. That is, its magnitude is fixed but not the direction because S dash frame is a rotating frame of reference. It is known that an arbitrary small rotation delta theta about some direction n vector, where n vector is an unit vector passing through the origin, brings about a change in vector L given by delta L vector equal to delta theta into n cap cross product with L vector. Therefore, delta L delta t equal to delta theta delta t n cap cross product with L vector. Taking limit as delta t tending to 0, we have d dt of L vector equal to omega n cap cross L vector. This gives omega vector cross L vector. That is, we get the cross product of omega and L vector. Using this, we can consider that I vector can be taken as the position vector of a point on the OX dash axis, which revolve about the point O with an angular velocity omega vector. Therefore, d dt of I vector, that is time rate of change of I vector, gives the cross radial velocity of that point equals to omega vector cross I vector. Similarly, dj vector dt equal to omega vector cross j vector, dk vector dt equal to omega vector cross k vector. Let us substitute the expressions for ddt of I vector, ddt of j vector and ddt of k vector already obtained in equation 1.1, and we get this equation, which is ddt of alpha vector. These terms have been written as it is. Here we have substituted the expressions for ddt of I vector, which is cross product of omega vector with I vector. Similarly, ddt of j vector is the cross product of omega vector and j vector. Ddt of k vector is the cross product of omega vector and k vector. We get the second term on the right hand side. The terms within the first bracket has been written as it is. The last term is written as omega vector cross product of alpha 1 I vector plus alpha 2 into j vector plus alpha 3 into k vector. Here we are considering the cross product or vector product of two vector quantities, which is omega vector and alpha 1 I vector plus alpha 2 j vector plus alpha 3 k vector. Now, ddt of alpha 1 into I vector plus ddt of alpha 2 into j vector plus ddt of alpha 3 into k vector can be written as del del t of alpha vector, and alpha 1 I vector plus alpha 2 j vector plus alpha 3 k vector is nothing but alpha vector. So, we get omega vector cross product with alpha vector. Let us consider the applications of the previous result. First of all, consider absolute velocity. Absolute velocity v vector is the first order ordinary derivative of r vector with respect to time t, which can be written as first order partial derivative of r vector with respect to time t plus omega vector cross r vector. Here cross means we are considering the vector product of two vector quantities or cross product of two vector quantities omega vector and r vector. Next, let us consider absolute acceleration. Acceleration is denoted by small f vector, which can be written as ddt of v vector. Ddt indicates that we are considering the ordinary derivative, which can be written as del del t of v vector plus omega vector cross v vector. In operator form, we can write it as del del t plus omega vector cross operated on v vector. Substituting the expression for v vector already obtained, that is del del t of r vector plus omega vector cross r vector, we get the right hand side of this equation, which can be written explicitly in the form del 2 r vector del t 2 plus del del t of omega vector cross r vector plus omega vector cross del del t of r vector plus omega vector cross del del t of r vector plus omega vector cross omega vector cross r vector. Here cross indicates that we are considering the vector products. We obtained this equation just operating del del t plus omega vector cross on del r vector del t plus omega vector cross r vector, and we get this equation. The equation can be written by combining the common terms in the last line. If we denote the second order partial derivative of r vector with respect to time t as small f dash vector, which is the acceleration in frame s dash, and del omega vector del t cross r vector plus omega vector cross r vector as f vector t, which is the acceleration due to transport, and denoting 2 omega vector cross del r vector del t as f vector c, which is the Coriolis acceleration for a particle fixed in s dash, we get del r vector del t equal to 0 as well as del 2 r vector del t 2 equal to 0, since the particle is fixed in frame s dash. So, we get these results. Therefore, from these expressions, we have f dash vector equal to 0, f c vector equal to 0, since del r vector del t vanishes. Then we get f vector equal to f vector t, that is the transport acceleration. For a particle of mass small m acted on by a force capital F vector, which is the actual force, Newton's second law gives small m small f vector equal to capital F vector. If capital F vector is the force acting on the particle of mass small m, then the law of motion in fixed frame S is given by small m into small f vector equal to capital F vector, or small m into f dash vector plus ft vector plus fc vector equal to capital F vector. Or m f dash vector equal to capital F vector minus m ft vector minus m fc vector. This is the modified Newton's law in the frame S dash, where to the actual force capital F vector, the two fictitious forces minus m ft vector and minus m fc vector are to be added. Now, minus m ft vector is intimately related to the centrifugal force in the following way. If the rotation is uniform, that is omega vector equal to constant, then ddt of omega vector equal to 0, which gives del del t of omega vector plus omega vector cross omega vector equal to 0, which again gives del del t of omega vector equal to 0, since omega vector cross omega vector is 0 always. In that case, minus m ft vector equal to minus m del omega vector del t cross r vector minus m omega vector cross r vector equal to minus m omega vector cross r vector equal to minus capital F c f vector, where capital F c f vector is the centrifugal force. The Coriolis force is given by F Coriolis vector equal to minus m F c vector equal to minus m 2 omega vector cross del t of r vector. The transverse force equal to F t v vector equal to minus m del del t of omega vector cross r vector. Remarks. Transverse and centrifugal forces depend on position r vector of the particle. Whereas Coriolis force depends on velocity del del t of r vector. Centrifugal force is independent of the speed of the object in the rotating frame. Now, we are going to obtain equation of motion of a particle in a rotating frame of reference. Consider figure 1.2. Let C be the center of the earth, which is supposed to be a sphere. O be a point either on the earth's surface or a point very close to the earth's surface. The point O is fixed relative to the earth. The earth is supposed to be rotating with uniform angular velocity omega vector about an axis cz, which is defined by unit vector small z vector. Let C O vector equal to r 0 vector. Let P be the position of the particle at any time t, whose position vector is given by r vector. That is, O P vector equal to r vector relative to a frame of reference rigidly attached to the earth at O, and hence rotating with the same angular velocity omega vector. Let ddt is used to denote the rate of change of a vector with respect to a frame in which the earth has an angular velocity omega vector, whereas del del t is used to denote the rate of change of a vector with respect to a frame rigidly attached to the earth at all. Absolute velocity of P can be obtained as V vector equal to ddt of Cp vector equal to ddt of r0 vector plus r vector equal to del del t of r0 vector plus r vector plus omega vector cross r0 vector plus r vector, which gives del del t of r vector plus omega vector cross r0 vector plus r vector. This on simplification gives del del t of r vector plus omega vector cross r0 vector plus omega vector cross r vector. Since del r0 del t equal to 0, r0 being a constant vector with respect to the frame of reference at O. Now, absolute acceleration at the position P is given by small f vector, which is ddt of v vector, where v vector is the velocity vector. Ddt of v vector can be written as del del t of v vector plus omega vector cross v vector. In operator form, we can write it as del del t plus omega vector cross operated on v vector. If we substitute the expression for v vector already obtained, then we get the result written in the next line. After performing the partial derivative and taking the cross product with omega vector, we get the result which has been written in the next two lines. That is, we have f vector equal to second order partial derivative of r vector with respect to time t plus del del t of omega vector cross r o vector plus del del t of omega vector cross r vector plus omega vector cross del del t of r vector plus omega vector cross del del t of r vector plus omega vector cross r 0 vector plus omega vector cross r vector. We get these terms from the previous operation. Here cross means we are considering the cross product between two vectors. The similar terms can be combined, and combining the similar terms, we can write it in equation 1.4. Let us define apparent acceleration due to gravity. This is denoted by small g vector, which is the acceleration of a free particle which is at rest relative to the frame which is rigidly attached to the earth. So, g vector is the value of f vector when r vector is equal to 0 vector, del del t of r vector is also equal to 0 vector, and omega vector equal to 0 vector. Substituting these in the expression of f vector, we get g vector equal to del 2 r vector del t 2. Next, let us define the true acceleration due to gravity, which is denoted by small g dash vector. This is the acceleration of the same particle which is at rest with respect to a frame in which the earth is rotating. Here we are considering that the earth is rotating. So, g dash vector is the value of f vector when r vector equal to 0 vector, del del t of r vector equal to 0 vector, but omega vector is non-zero. As the particle is fixed, so del del t of r vector vanishes. We are considering at the position p, so r vector equal to 0 vector. From the expression of f vector, substituting these quantity, we get g dash vector equal to del 2 r vector del t 2 plus omega vector cross r 0 vector. Substituting g vector is equal to del 2 r vector del t 2, we get the right hand side of this equation. Now, the equations of motion of the particle is given by m into f vector. This gives mass into acceleration, and on the right hand side we get capital F vector plus m into g dash vector. Capital F vector is the applied force, and this is the force due to gravity, mass into acceleration due to gravity. So, the left hand side and right hand side are consistent. We have already mentioned that F vector is the external force acting on the particle of mass m in addition to gravity. If we substitute m into g dash vector on the left hand side and then dividing by m, we get f vector minus g dash vector equal to capital F vector divided by m, which can be written in explicit form as second order partial derivative of r vector with respect to time t plus 2 into omega vector cross del del t of r vector plus omega vector cross r vector minus g vector. This is the value of f vector minus g dash vector. So, we can write it in the left hand side, replacing this, and we get the equation given by del 2 r vector del t 2 plus 2 omega vector cross del del t of r vector plus omega vector cross r vector, which is equal to f vector divided by m plus g vector. Here cross means we are considering the cross product of two vector quantities. Neglecting omega square, if omega is very small, we can neglect omega square. We get the final equation, which is del 2 r vector del t 2 plus 2 omega vector cross del del t of r vector equal to capital F vector divided by m plus g vector. Here we have neglected the air resistance also. We have already mentioned that rotating frame are non-inertial frame. Earth's rotation play a significant role in the hydrodynamics of atmosphere and ocean. So, we have to develop the equations of motion in such a frame. In this module, we have discussed the equations of motion in the viewpoint of a rotating coordinate frame.